Welcome to another episode of Just Filed, where we talk about the context around and substance of a recent ACA Connects filing. Today, we're focused on the association's reply comments in the FCC proceeding entitled Addressing the Homework Gap through the E-Rate Program. This filing was due on February 23rd. Once again, I'm here with Tom Cohen, outside counsel to ACA Connects and partner at the law firm of Kelly Dry. It's good to be with you again, Tom.
Same here, Ross. Great to be with you.
As discussed on episode one earlier this month, the FCC sought comment on a set of petitions that asked the FCC to allow E-rate funded services and equipment to be used off campus to enable remote learning for the duration of the pandemic. On February 16th, ACA Connects filed initial comments, which we previously discussed. So Tom, what did others have to say in their comments?
In general, Ross, there is unanimity that we needed to have this emergency program established by the FCC, and the sooner the better. Now, once you got past that high level unanimity, the schools and their associations and their other supporters all said, let's go fast, more, we want this to happen. The providers were on the same wavelength in terms of let's get the program established, but they were a little more cautious about certain aspects of how it should be developed.
Got it. So it's, I'm sensing from you, there weren't many surprises in terms of what parties said.
No, I mean, we're in an emergency. And everybody knows in-need students, for them, the classroom is at home now. And so they may not have quality broadband connectivity, and we need to get it to them. So there's agreement on that. Then there are just all the issues, though. How should the program actually work?
Yeah. And what did ACA Connects have to say in our replies?
Well, what we tried to do is see what our colleagues in the industry also said, and most of them were on the, again, same wavelength as us, which is this needs to be a limited, targeted program to solve the problem we have. In-need students who don't have broadband connectivity for remote learning. They also said, because it's an emergency program, let's keep it limited in time, and let's make sure we can get really quick connectivity, that is, rely on existing providers. The third piece was the money should be spent going forward. It's a limited amount of money, limited pot that's out there. In addition, many schools had no idea they would get funding for this. So we shouldn't give them money for what they've already done. Let's keep it, fixed to what we're going to happen in the future. And then finally, give schools discretion to make this program work within accountability, frameworks.
Got it. Thanks, Tom. And a copy of the ACA Connects filing can be found on the ACA Connects website, and a link to the filing is included below. Parties only had 7 days to file reply comments, Tom. That's generally quick. So what can be read into the short time frame for parties to submit their views?
You're right, Ross. It's incredibly quick. You got to read everybody's comments and then figure out what you need to say all within a week. That said, this indicates how important this effort is. And it also, people should keep in mind, this is now the heart of the Democrats' agenda now that they've taken over. I mean, you're working on the emergency broadband benefit program, right? We've got this E-rate program. There's going to be more. Even after the emergency, the E-rate program is going to get expanded on the Democrats' watch.
Yeah. Telehealth too. So they're ticking off right. All the ways that broadband during the pandemic and be helpful for people who are at home. So what's next for ACA Connects advocacy on this matter?
Well, one, we'll get with our allies, see where we join together and what we need to do with the FCC. At the same time, the new stimulus legislation has $7+ billion for a somewhat similar program. And that's likely to be enacted within several weeks. So what's going to happen is that new program is going to meet up with this proceeding. And so probably, and I'm guessing, you know, April, May, these are all going to come together and this new program is going to start rolling and it's going to have a lot of money behind it.
Yeah. Is there anything that ACA Connects members should be doing now in anticipation of possible FCC action on this matter?
Well, I mean, first you need to, if you're not already familiar with the E-rate program, become familiar with it. There are lots of rules, lots of requirements, and you better know them before participating. I suggest everybody go to the website of USAC, the Universal Service Administrative Company, which really will help educate you on that. In addition, you know, most of our members have great relationships with their communities, with their schools. They need to get with them because what's going to happen is the schools are going to quickly try to figure out who can provide this at-home connectivity. And so you want to be in line for that.
Yeah. And in some cases, it may be the local broadband provider who is more knowledgeable about what the FCC is about to do than the school itself. And so not all schools have to apply, correct, in order to be able to gain the money and use it for this purpose. And so, you know, the provider can help educate this, bring the school around to doing it as well, huh?
Right. Well, right. I mean, you're going to need, the way E-rate works is schools bring a budget to USAC and that gets approved. And then through competitive bidding, they figure out who can provide the service. Somewhat similar is going to happen here, maybe, you know, a bit different because of the need for speed to get this done. But yes, if you can begin to educate the school about your broadband service, where it's available, what it costs and alike, that will help that, the educational institution.
All right, Tom, thank you for being with us. To viewers out there, please don't hesitate to leave comments below on this episode. And I look forward to seeing you soon on the next episode of Just Filed. Have a good day.